Study8Online.com.
Yeah, no, I, so they spent, and she's from Dundalk.
Right.
And she has a kid.
Okay. Oh, okay. Jesus.
So, we're in Baltimore, dude.
Yeah, you're hitting all the check marks.
You say okay, but it was a lot of fodder for Scott
of
and Justin.
Of course! Right. We do a comedy show. Jesus.
So I wasn't able to go on a date with this female because she happened to hear the break. So she went ahead and texted me and said, yeah, I don't think this is going to work out. I don't know who the hell you think you are or who your show thinks you are.
Oh, my God.
But you don't even know me. They don't know me.
You don't know me.
And to you call don't me, know me.
And to call me the names you call me, blah, blah, blah. So
yeah, they called her fat.
They called her fat, they called her a hog, they called her all sorts of things, man.
Can you bring her profile up?
Yeah. Sure. Go on to
So, wait,
so the date didn't even happen.
Didn't happen.
No.
Because
no,
you guys blew
happen.
Up his spot so
completely
much.
Completely
blew
it
like,
up.
F you guys.
Don't look at me. That was Justin's idea. He wanted to do the break.
Oh, you piled on too, Scott.
Of course, I followed his lead. We got to do a show.
It's
what
like
do you want me to do? Not
girl,
talk?
Every time there's a girl with a little bit of interest, I never get.
Oh, stop it. You met her on Plenty of Fish. You didn't even talk to her. It was strictly set up through text. You never even called. You called her once.
Yeah, no, we
didn't even know this girl.
We talked. Yeah, well, there you go.
And Greg.
Greg with two G's, 410.
The N two G's?
G-R-E-G-G. Greg with two G's. Yeah, because Greg with one G was taken.
G-R-E-G-G.
Yep, 410.
Yep.
And you can just pass me the keyboard. I'll put in the password.
Okay.
So I don't need you going.
Yeah. Here.
See, that's one of the smartest things I've ever heard you say, Greg.
Yeah, well.
Because if you're trying to do all this, first of all, you shouldn't be doing it on company time.
All right, here.
I wasn't doing it on company time.
Yeah, but if you're doing it in front of everybody that's looking for something to make fun of you.
This whole thing was set up while you were here.
Okay.
Was every last detail of it was set up.
No, not true at all. It was set
when
up
you were doing the promo on Thursday.
I mean, I was texting
over,
her. I was texting her.
I looked over. You were stopping working on the promo every 3 minutes to text.
Where is it? My matches?
No.
Will respond?
No.
I got sent message?
He just ran over there. He does not want him poking through that.
Stop making that noise, you idiot. Jesus.
That was her.
They said this girl was fat?
That's what I said, dude.
God, you guys. So naive.
Oh, wait a minute.
So naive to the
it's
internet
pictures.
It's
because of these stupid angles.
Yeah.
Well,
these angles that they're
okay,
playing.
I will say this. I will say this.
I think she looks gorgeous.
She number one, she's...
Oh, she's very pretty.
She's beautiful.
That's all I'm trying
to
say.
See.
You know who she's built like, Scott?
I mean, I don't know how you can tell based on the photos, but
I'm
go
sick.
Ahead.
He's right, Mickey. I mean, look at it.
You can't say who she's built like. There's no body picture.
There's nothing. It's a headshot.
She looks kind of Hot Topic, though. Like.
And she's looking up, so you don't know if she's got a double chin or not.
She's not looking up here.
The one I saw, she was...
I said she looked kind of like Mila Kunis.
The only one she's looking up is here. The whole body length shot. She's got gigantic boobs.
Yeah,
she's
I'll never know.
Really pretty.
Not to mention you don't know when those pictures were taken.
Exactly. Could have been.
Yeah, Justin's
10 years
acting
ago.
Like he's doing me a favor. You know, he's like, "Oh, you're welcome. You didn't want any of that. Come on."
Well, you will never really know, but he could have been.
Did you try to apologize?
We talked a little bit over the weekend. She wished me a happy birthday and all that, and so we'll see.
Oh, so she's fine.
I mean,
yeah, she's fine, but she ain't going on a date with him.
She's just not eating anymore.
She'll run it back.
She's also throwing up in a bathroom somewhere because you guys are such
Give it some time. She'll run it back.
First of all, this girl's very pretty.
Thank you.
She's got very pretty eyes.
I agree.
She's got huge boobs, it appears.
I saw those.
She's got huge mams, huge mammaries. Hey, look at those sweater calves.
The only thing that's a little bit, I don't even want to use the word weird, but I would say... interesting, I guess. Different is the nose piercing.
I told you she was Hot Topic. I told you.
Yeah.
She's like, she looks like.
I mean, she's 25, so I mean, yeah, I think
I know.
She's.
I know.
You ever dated a woman, a single mother?
Not a mother of one.
No.
Because there's a lot. I mean, obviously you won't meet the child until
Shut up, man.
A couple of dates when she figures out that you're safe to bring around. But see, if you meet the kid
the
first night, then you're screwed.
So you've dated a mother of two.
No, not true. I didn't
four.
Mother of four.
Stop
four.
It. Yeah. Stop it.
Did you meet the kids right
four?
Off the bat?
Was it not four kids?
Can you relax
you
for a second?
You banged a woman with four kids.
You're saying dating. It was one date that he set up for me, and I went in blind.
Why would you set him up with a woman with four kids?
Because he knew I was going to get laid and he's a good man.
Because then she's got five kids. Come on.
I went into that thing blind. I didn't know she had four kids. You got to be kidding me. I learned that when I was there with her.
First of all, you're going to tell me you didn't know she had that many kids when you went on the date.
Yes. She told me she had that many kids when I was... I knew she was a mother, but
Dude, you talked about it in the meeting before you went.
You told me she was 34. That was the only information you gave me.
And I said she's got kids.
Not four.
So you're sitting across from her and she drops the bomb and so she's got four kids?
Yes. Oh my God, his eyes got as big as saucers.
Goddamn minivan. It was crazy.
So what? Is she hot?
Come on. She's probably listening. Let's not put this stuff out.
She's going to have five kids now? I said you can't automatically rule her out
because she's got four kids. There's probably women out there smoking hot with four kids.
Listen, I think she's attractive. I do. I think she's attractive.
I'm not trying to sound ungrateful by any means. Thank you for setting me up.
How many kids does Dennis have and his wife?
Five.
Five. That chick's smoking hot.
Yeah. She's very hot.
Yeah.
She likes redheads, too.
Not really, Greg.
So wait, this date from Friday, at what point did she bail?
After the break, and then she seemed a little cool after the break. I texted her and said, you know, because she said, I'm listening.
Right.
And she said she wasn't a fan before. Sorry for that.
Is that her?
I don't know if that's her.
It's probably her. Give Greggy a second chance.
Is it her?
No, it's not her.
Give Greggy a second chance. We didn't mean to ruin it for him. We were just having fun.
Can I say that name?
We were just making jokes.
Can you what?
Can I say her name? Did we say her name?
No, don't use her name.
Take her to Hot Topic. Buy her some...
Stop, Kat. You're just being a bitch.
Buy her some buttons and some purple spray hair dye.
Go buy a couple of onesies and some Gerber. Buy some onesies and some Gerber. Yeah. Head over to her house.
Some Slipknot onesies for her kid. And I think it'll be all right.
Oh, man.
Go get some Granite. Animals.
Maybe an ICP pacifier.
Yeah, ICP.
All I'm saying is
take her to see Guar.
It could have been a much better birthday weekend. You totally would have gotten laid too if we didn't blow up your spot.
That was where we ended that break.
Is you're so getting laid this weekend.
That was another thing that pissed her off. She thought to be like, oh what? You're getting. I mean, Amelia was talking about bringing condoms. Justin was talking about getting it in.
Bringing condoms is not. That's not an insult. You just got to be prepared, whether it happens or not.
Listen, I'll stop right now. Because this is hilarious to me. You know, obviously, one day I'll probably, although I don't want to, maybe go out with somebody,
mm-hmm.
and. I think about all this, and, like, I hear, like, it's such a different world for
me. Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Like, the thought of just meeting a girl online and knowing, like, pretty much it's in the bag you're going to get laid, like, that is so foreign to me. Like, I still think you
have
to go out.
There's no guarantee, but, yeah.
Like, I still think you have to go out a couple times, sure. Get to know each other.
Yeah.
Like,
listen, will you call her and apologize and see if we can get this date back on?
Let's do it right now.
Will you do that? Will you not be a dick and say, look, I'm
sorry. What do you mean? Like, yeah, of course. Yes. I'll do whatever you want.
You gotta say, I'm sorry I called you fat.
Give me the number. Quit talking.
Of course I'm so. We were just doing it. You know, we were just having some fun. That's what I want you to do.
That's what I want you to do.
We're going to call her right now?
And you're going to say you're sorry so I can get a date out of this, though?
Does she know we're calling?
Tell her you're calling. I don't know.
Scott,
I mean,
pick up the warm line.
You know, she's probably so hungry.
Damn it. Scott, here. It's line. Scott's going to call right now.
That would be very helpful because I'm out of date now.
Listen to me. First of all, this girl is, I think she's sexy as hell.
That's what I thought, too.
I don't know how you can tell.
See, that's my
point.
There really isn't a way you can tell. There's not a way you can tell.
The only way you can tell is if you go on a date. That's the only way you can tell.
You can't tell.
I lost my chance at that, Amelia.
What's not sexy about that?
Those are pictures. She can do all kinds of stuff to those pictures. She could have cystic acne and you don't know it. She could. Those pictures could be from however long ago. You don't know.
She may have leprosy and lost her nose.
She could have leprosy. She could be molting.
She is very
molting.
Perhaps. I can tell this girl is pretty. All right, we're gonna. Here she is.
Don't use her name.
Stop. Stop.
Don't use her name.
Stop. Good morning. How are you?
I'm fine. How are you?
Can tell me a name that I can call you on the air.
Oh my God! What did he call me today? Cindy.
All right, Cindy. Now, you and this is Mickey, by the way. I was not here Friday.
I know.
To partake in this horrendous attack on you that occurred. Now, listen, I'm looking at your pictures on the.
Tell Greg to show you the one from that I took over this weekend. I took a body shot so he could tell you guys.
Where's the body shot picture?
I forgot about that.
Let me see it.
She was in a dress. It's different.
Where's his phone?
Give me the phone.
I want to see that picture.
Listen, I wanted to. Listen, Greg is a good guy. We love Greg. I just want to apologize if we ruined your or we put a bad taste in your mouth and you felt like you had to cancel the date. I would like you to reconsider.
Thank you, Scott.
Maybe this weekend I'll even throw in. What happened to the $60 I gave you for the date?
I had a great birthday with it. It's terrific.
You son of a bitch!
I shot you $60. I said these shots are on Scott Reardon tonight, and that's what I did with that $60.
You son of a bitch!
All right, now.
Listen, maybe I'll throw in some more money. I want you guys to go out, have a good time. You sleep with Greg. We'll see what happens.
Come on, man.
Now, Cindy, let me.
Well,
ask...
you know I have a kid.
Yeah, you
so
put
I'm
out.
Down
you get
that
it
on the first night, right?
Right. Yeah, you obviously put out.
See, I'm just gonna point it at him.
Yeah. Now listen.
Like
so you're single, right?
Yes.
Okay. Oh, how old's your child?
He's 22 months. He's
wow.
He's 22 in December.
Okay, so you're pretty much back to your fighting weight that before you had the baby, right?
Yeah.
So this is who you are now is a representation of who you are.
Exactly.
All right.
And I'm comfortable with who I am, even if you're not.
Look at me. I
tell you what, you got a great rack.
Even as my MySpace angles and shit.
Well, dump that a minute. Dump that. That's okay. You can't say that word. Now, let me see the picture of her in the dress, Greg.
Yeah. I'm sorry. I'm still looking for it.
Did you send him
she
a lot of angry
text.
Texts in a row? Because I do that sometimes, you know, when a guy.
Pissed.
I'll send him like 8 to 10 text messages saying, you know.
Rapid fire, yeah.
No.
I'm going to kill your family, make you watch, stuff like that.
Okay. It wasn't that
just
bad.
Me?
I was irritated because we didn't even go on a date yet. And I was uncomfortable with the whole radio thing to begin with. And then, like, before we even met, there was, like, an issue with it where, I mean, the word hog is pretty harsh. Like, that's a really mean word.
Yeah, I would. I'm looking at your picture right now. I would not use the word hog.
Who used the word hog?
You did.
Justin did.
Justin did.
Yeah, so don't blame me.
We were also in the context of talking about pictures that people have put up on MySpace and Facebook over the years, and you can't deny that.
It's no mystery.
No,
yeah.
That's what
goes down.
So,
and we didn't
know. I
also
don't take pictures and, like, put pictures of my you know, butt on.
Right.
On like the computer for everyone to see.
Now,
I am a mother. I have a little more respect.
We're looking out for Greg. We didn't want to have him to like go out to dinner with you and then you order 2 entrees or something like that. I mean,
and,
he doesn't have a lot
like
of money.
Greg. I like Greg, but let me put it this way. Have you looked at Greg?
Yeah, that's why. No,
Greg?
Of course.
Come on.
That's the other thing.
Does he
Jesus.
Have the right to like, say anything no. about anyone's weight? Well,
I don't say anything about anybody's
listen,
weight.
Cindy, listen, Cindy.
You're doing him a favor now that I think about
yeah,
it.
Yeah, listen. Listen.
She's a little heavy.
Let me explain something to you. I would not call you skinny. I would not
okay,
call
I wouldn't call me skinny either.
Right, nope. But I would not call you fat.
Well,
I would call
you wouldn't call you sloppy.
I
right.
would call is it fair to say that you are like full figured?
I'm full figured and I've had a child.
Listen to me. I'm looking at your picture. Now granted.
Look, you and Greg are like a perfect pair.
What's the matter? Yeah, okay, whatever. She has boobs. I don't have boobs, but you know what? Her arms are a little big.
Yeah. Well,
Cat.
Listen, Cat has anorexia and AIDS.
I do. And AIDS.
So it's
and
not
bulimia.
Fair. Right. So it's not fair for her to judge. But listen, Cindy, I want to tell you something. I think you are incredibly sexy. You know who you're built like? And people won't believe this. You were built like what Marilyn Monroe and Jane Mansfield was built like.
You should take her out. Screw Greg.
Yeah, you want to go out with me? Stop it.
You're married. Don't you have a ton of kids?
No. Well, first of all, I have 3 kids.
A ton of kids. Don't you have is this coming from a woman who has a 22-month?
I have one child.
Yeah,
one.
Well, trust me. You get
that's enough, sweetheart.
If I sneeze on you, you'll have twins the rate I'm going.
No, man.
Listen.
All right, so wait, we got to go.
Back to Greg.
You're going out with Greg again, okay?
I did say that I would if he had time this week because he's so busy and he hates this word popular that he can't make time for me. But
he told you he was popular.
He
didn't say any of that. Come on,
just making assumptions because I'm so famous. That's all.
What is happening?
I'm just kidding.
He really believes.
All right, we gotta go.
Yeah, we gotta go.
You two
Cindy.
Go on your little dating sites or texty text, whatever you do. Set it up. You go out. You have a good time. You sleep together. You have 2 kids. It's gonna be great.
And then we talk about you on the air. That's how it goes.
Cool. That sounds great.
Yeah, when she starts dating Greg, she's already gonna have 2 kids.
You know. You know why I want this? You know why I want this date to work? Honestly, because
why?
I want
Tell
Cindy.
Why.
I want you to come back on the air. And describe Greg's lovemaking.
Oh, great.
Oh, my yeah. God.
That if it gets to that
happen.
Point.
That might, if happen. It gets to that point, that might actually be perfect
payback.
You know, revenge
You're
for
damn
this.
Right
yeah.
it will.
Yeah.
He don't care, though. He doesn't
She's
care.
She's already assuming it's going to be
yeah,
bad.
He wouldn't care because he got some at that point.
Yeah, yeah.
I would assume it would be bad, too.
Yeah. So you're actually, Cindy, you're the one that ends up being the idiot if you actually have sex with him.
Yeah. Cindy.
Excuse me.
Well, go
maybe, well, maybe I won't advertise it on the air, then.
No, we will.
Probably a smart move.
Well, good to meet you, honey. And Scott does feel really bad for what he called you.
Have a good day, guys.
All right, you too. Bye-bye. You're crazy if you don't go out with this girl. She sounds level-headed.
I didn't have the option to go out with her earlier.
Very grounded.
Mm-hmm. I'm good. Nikki, Amelia, and